round one. Fight.
There. There is. there is a new movie. Oh, it's not the one. This day is just going real well. This is what happens when you wake up a half hour late.
It's okay. I got it right here. You want me to play it?
Okay.
Why did you wake up a half hour late?
Yeah, why'd you wake up late, buddy?
I woke up a half hour late because I couldn't get out of bed. I kind of dragged myself out of bed from 10 or 15 minutes than normal, later than normal. And then, well, before I did, then I had to take care of business.
Dude, I did too this morning.
Oh, really?
I was just about to share that.
Did you
really take care of business?
Yeah, I had to.
I did too. Did
you medical reasons.
Did you guys
me too.
Crank? Did you guys crank?
Yes.
Misha.
Hand to God.
Misha,
this morning,
cut the
I was
feed
like...
and play a song. Cut the feed and play a song. Okay, we're off?
Yeah.
Okay. At 4:40 today, I was off. Were we all...
Are we synced up at this point?
Have we synced up? Like the way an office full of women, their menstrual cycles, has our crank schedule synced up? Yes. Oh, my God.
Hand to God.
Same.
4:40, 4:45. Oh. I was right above where I'm sitting now in my bed, pleasuring myself.
I was too.
Dude, I thought it felt different. I knew there was
I felt an energy.
It's like when a twin gets hurt on the other side of the country.
The other twin feels it. Wait a minute. No, it like I found my hand like floating to my midsection and the other hand caught it. Like, no, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Like it was more of like a full body shiver, and that's because we were synced up.
All of us synced up today. I wouldn't believe all of us at the same time just erupted.
My mind is cracking open right now.
Oh, my God. We have... Remember back in the day in the 50s when there was no such thing as a bloodborne illness and you'd sort of cut your hand and your buddy would cut his and you'd shake and become blood brothers?
Blood brothers. Yeah.
We became this morning brothers, all right? We are now...
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's what we are. So, sorry, but we are all now... We're relatives.
Oh, wow. Oh, this is the greatest moment of my life.
This is great. Mish, we're going to go to music at 6:30, and Amelia's going to start at 7. Because there's nothing else to get to.
Well, as I was saying, the...
Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah. You couldn't get out of bed, and then you had to medically please yourself.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And then I had to take a shower because I hadn't taken a shower in at least 4 days. At least. Mm-hmm. At least four. This is insane.
What have you done, though, to really stink yourself up?
But can I give you a pro to that con? The good side of doing that?
Make them feel
better. How good does the shower feel now, though?
You know what? It doesn't feel very good. In fact,
really?
I don't want to take the shower because I want to just... not take a shower. I actually have to force myself to take the shower.
No, I know that, but once you're in it and you're like, you're finally getting clean again, doesn't it feel like a better clean?
No, really? It doesn't. It really doesn't.
I took a hot shower yesterday, and I have that Dr. Squatch soap that has the sand in it and the coconut shells and like an exfoliate. I was in there for like 20 minutes, 30 minutes. It felt so good because I was so gross.
Yeah.
In fact, I am thinking about getting a chair for my shower.
My parents have one.
I don't want to stand up in the shower anymore. It's too much effort.
My 76-year-old father has one of those.
It's
ancient.
Too much effort. What do I have to stand for?
Like a little metal folding chair and just sit there?
I was thinking more of, remember that meme after the earthquake?
Oh, with the one that tipped over like a plastic lawn chair.
Yeah, like a white plastic lawn chair in the corner.
It might start brown, but it'll end white. I can bring you one. I've got a bunch of them, and some of them fresh, never using, sitting in my used, sitting in my shed if you'd like.
I just, it's just, you know?
People are checking in, by the way. Uh-huh. Oh, my God. I can't even keep up with the text. Somebody says, guys, me too, 4:45.
What?
Same for me this morning, guys. I'm right there with you. Me too.
Is 12:30 time now at 4:40 a.m.? Is it the 4:40 crew? Shout out to the 4:40 crew, okay?
Women sync up their periods. Men sync up self-pleasure.
Yeah, we do.
Holy crap, I 100% took care of business this morning as well at 5 a.m.
And the only way I can take care of it is to masturbate.
Somebody wants to know, what is the medical condition, Josh? They can't remember.
I had in my early 20s, I had a prostatic congestion, and the doctor ordered me to take care of business. True story.
Mm-hmm. It was clogged up.
It was clogged up.
I'll never have that problem.
No, crusty. At this point, if balls could get dehydrated, okay, it looks like a sad apricot. I would love for the doctor to have maybe filmed the reveal of just these two gigantic testicles. Like, were you ever seen the guy that's walking around in Pakistan with elephantitis?
Yeah. There was that guy in Vegas, remember?
Yes.
The guy on the bus?
Yes! I imagine that was you.
Elephantitis testicles or something like that.
You've just got these two big sloshing walnuts. It just sounds
Didn't that
like...
guy wear a hooded sweatshirt as pants?
Yes!
And he put the balls in the hood?
The balls in the hood! Oh, that should be a great name for like some sexual inner city movie, Balls in the Hood. Josh's bees were like two big Turkey Hill iced tea gallon jugs sloshing back and forth. The doctor was like, you got to get this out now. That milk has curdled.
Oh,
sorry.
Last night's winning lottery numbers.
Can I ask you a question,
please?
Okay.
Was it good?
No, it's rarely good. It's
really?
Rarely good. I never feel like satisfied after it. It feels like
waves of guilt.
The tank is still about 3/4 full.
Oh my God.
Really?
Well, get back at it.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Maybe not 3/4. Maybe like
half.
Half or a quarter. It's just, it's not. I just don't,
you know,
just not happening for me anymore.
You know what you got to do.
No, I don't want to do
else.
That. I already
find
know what
else.
You're going
to
say.
Find someone else to do it for you.
Oh, I thought you were going to say
it
something
helps.
Else.
I volunteer as tribute. I'm putting my hands in the air like it was the Hunger Games in here. I got my three fingers pointed towards the live wire camera. Yeah, never do I wrap up a session and go, well, that was some of it. No.
Really?
Yeah.
You always are. Wow.
I'm spent. That's it.
Maybe I have a condition. Maybe I have a second condition.
Yeah. You have a very active reproductive system. There are some people, and I don't know the term. It's the same thing that Andre the Giant suffered from. Paul White suffered from. The guy that played Jaws in the James Bond film suffered from. But there's a condition. I believe the guy's name was Richard Kiel. Acromyalgia, where your body just makes too much growth hormone. The no one ever cinches the hose. Your body just continues to grow until it literally grows itself to
right,
death.
Yeah.
Your body just might make way too much. That's it. It just you might have a condition. You could quit here and just move in next door to like a fertility clinic.
Am I a nymphomaniac?
Misha, could you clear the entire schedule next week? Like whatever you have? Because that's all we're going to talk about is that Josh is a nymphomaniac.
And I think
was
you're,
I the was I the high school slut?
Josh was the school slut.
And I think you're being very pessimistic and negative. I tend to look at things you know, don't look at them as half empty. Why don't you look at the glasses half full? The testes is half full.
I think you meant to say, look at the paper towel is half full. There's plenty more to go.
I mean, you can look at it two ways, right? They're either half empty or half full. I don't know what's better. What would be better in this case?
In this case, I'd go half empty. God, great point. Yeah, because Josh wants them fully empty. Yeah.
Anyway.
Wow. Okay. Well, if you could just live stream the next session, because I do need to know what happens when Pompeii erupts up there in Boston. I've got to know. Okay. If you're our Peter North, I gotta know.
All right, I'll think about it.
We just set a new land speed record for me being horny. Now? We could just shut this show down and submit it to All Access for Program of the Year.